Save this life.
Keep pumping his chest. Do not stop.
Please hurry.
When seconds matter,
room 22, 95 out.
The men and women of Austin Travis County EMS,
can I turn your head the other way? Good job.
Respond to the challenge.
Stop!
For these medics, helping those in need isn't just a job, it's a passion. 2-year medic one, Selena Shia.
Are you hurting anywhere right now?
Describes how she joined the team.
When I was younger, the only thing I remember really wanting to do is becoming a Supreme Court justice. Sandra Day O'Connor has always been my hero. When I was, 5 or 6, that was the only way I really knew how to help people was become a judge. Are you doing all right?
Austin Travis County EMS is a continually growing department and seeks highly trained and certified EMS providers to join their team as a medic one.
When you hire into the system, you'll hire in as a medic one. And a medic one can be any certification level.
Once selected to the team,
okay, one time down and back.
Cadets eager to save lives must complete a 6-week-long training academy.
You ready?
No.
To be prepared for any emergency.
I got like 2 feet farther to
We ran up towers. We did a lot of physical stuff. And then we would do medicine. Or we would do outdoor training. So that would include swift water, extricating out of cars, learning how to deal with mass casualties.
Hey guys, flowers coming off. Yes, I need some help, man.
Hold on, tighten it off.
Medics have an office on wheels and spend a large amount of time on the road. Therefore, driving safely is a must, and cadets are put through a thorough driving course.
So get in through the first one and then find your straight point and get there. That'll keep you from hitting these cones.
The time that I did the best, I only hit 3 cones. But it was really cool to see some of our captains. They could just zip through the entire thing, which was really impressive.
During the academy, cadets are taught emergency vehicle operations, swift water rescue, and clinical guidelines to prepare them for the streets of Austin.
I'm just gonna check your blood pressure, okay? Graduation was at City Hall, and the chambers are super beautiful. So when Dr. Hinge put the stethoscope on, it was, a really powerful moment since we use that every day for every call to either take a blood pressure or listen to lung sounds. And it's a really nice stethoscope, so. In a lot of ways, it just made me take the job much more seriously. We are taking care of people, and we don't see life and death situations every day, but anybody who calls us needs help in some form or the other, and sometimes that's hard to remember with the large call volume that we do have.
Do you promise to keep the oath of service?
Chief, yes, sir!
After graduation, Medic 1s are enlisted with experienced Medic 2s and begin their exciting career.
Hopefully this medicine will make you feel better, okay?
Oh. You'll come in and work as a Medic 1 in our field until there's a Medic 2 opening. What that does is it gives you exposure into our system. You just can't do the skills. You're still thinking like one. You can never take that away.
Chief of EMS Ernesto Rodriguez takes us back 33 years when he first joined the ranks.
I've been in EMS since 1981. So that's before a lot of people were born. I remember my very first call, and we responded to a major car crash. It was probably one of the worst accidents I've ever seen. The moment I started helping out and contributing, I was hooked. I knew it's what I needed to do for the rest of my life.
We're 5 miles out right now.
Yeah.
Hey, go ahead and code 3. Her stats are 65 and not coming up, and I'm unable to get a blood pressure now.
Okay,
see you there. Bye.
Medic 13, upgraded, code 3.
I think a lot of people that choose to do EMS do it for the exact same reason that I did.
Your blood pressure's low, and the amount of oxygen you have in your blood is low, and your blood sugar's low.
Yeah.
Because they want to help somebody.
So, you're all kinds of low right now. So we're going to get you to the hospital where they can help you.
I think that's something that you always have to keep at the front of your thoughts, because the job that we do gets pretty tough sometimes. Keep that as your stabilizing force. You'll always enjoy it, and it'll always be worth doing.
1, 2, 3.
Austin Travis County EMS prides itself in being a pioneer in pre-hospital medical care.
I believe that we are one of the top EMS agencies out there, not because of where we are, but who we are and the name we've made for ourselves.
We're one of the leading organizations in cardiac resuscitations in the nation. And that's not by accident. That's because we worked for it. So a person that comes here could work on an ambulance as a basic medic. They can work as a paramedic, They can get involved in collapse rescue. We've got motorcycles. We've got all kinds of different ways to enable medics to go do what they love.
We want to give you the best equipment. We want to make sure you're safe. So we provide you with the best safety equipment possible. And we're always looking to the future. We don't want to stay stagnant here.
Dynamic duo medic team Melissa Hall.
Okay, so everything looks okay there.
And Teresa Peary.
We'll take good care of him.
Explain why they sought this thrilling career.
It's perfect for somebody that doesn't want to sit behind a desk all day. Or somebody who does really well in a setting where you have no idea what's going to happen.
You really have to be a unique person who really responds well to adrenaline. Who's really flexible and can really think on their feet.
Señora, toma medicina hoy?
Every day is different. And that's what makes this so fun.
Good evening, Brackenridge. This is Medic 13 inbound to your facility with 58-year-old male, 5'8-year-old male, patient chief complaint of groin pain, secondary to a hernia.
That question 13, we'll have a wheelchair on standby.
This really, truly is the best job ever.
How old are you?
55. All right, you don't look a day over 54. We say that all the time. We're riding this thing till the wheels fall off.
If somebody came to me tomorrow and said, you'll never work on an ambulance again, I really honestly don't know what I would do. Yeah. There's nothing else that I would rather do more. And there's no other department I'd rather work for. I moved 2,500 miles away, left everything I've ever known.
There's no other partner she'd want to work with either.
I know.
Tracy Hardy, a 15-year veteran, believes of the many benefits in EMS, small things can make the career rewarding.
The best part of our job is actually being there for the elderly.
Take some nice deep breaths, you're okay.
Or just the small things of making the changes in people's lives. So to us, we consider this a career, not a job.
It's different than any other job you'll work. You're on 24 hours or 12 hours at a time. And there's really no better feeling than knowing that, hey, I can make a difference to somebody.
Take a couple of nice deep breaths, okay?
Austin Travis County EMS is constantly evolving to remain on the forefront in emergency medicine.
All right, well, I do have the help on the way in.
Their passion is testament by having some of the highest cardiac arrest survival rates in the country.
How are we doing?
Emergency medical services offers some of the coolest jobs on the planet. Here in the city of Austin, we've got great benefits. We've got good pay, we've got good equipment, we've got a good environment, we've got awesome leadership. I can't think of any reason for somebody that's interested in a career in EMS why they wouldn't choose us. Coming here is a good opportunity. And if they want to learn more about it, just pick up the phone, call us, come visit. We're here.
Show you can help change the lives of the people we serve by joining Austin Travis County Emergency Medical Services. Visit atcems.org and complete a contact card to be notified of the next Medic One hiring process.